Hi, I'm Elena Nizhnik, and I'm AR Training Manager here at Snap. Lens Cloud powers a new generation of augmented reality experiences that are more dynamic, useful, and interactive than ever before. Lens Cloud features expand what developers can build in AR, leveling up lenses to be more impressive experiences. Let's talk through these features. With multi-user services, developers can build and create AR content for unique shared experiences. With updates to connected lenses, which allow you to pass and store data between devices running the same lens, and introduction of new high-level multi-user APIs, Lens Cloud makes it easier than ever to build collaborative experiences. Location-based AR builds on Snap's landmarkers and enables developers to expand their experiences by creating their own location-based content via custom location AR and cityscale AR. Storage services allows developers to expand how much content is available to their users. With persistent cloud storage, developers can now create experiences that save a user's preferences, progress, and more across multiple sessions. And with remote assets, we've extended file size restrictions by allowing developers to store up to 25 megabytes of content in the cloud and remotely fetch and load assets at runtime. Alongside nonprofit organization Marked by COVID and developer KR Graphics, Snapchat partnered to create a lens that uses AR to enable communities to memorialize and celebrate loved ones lost to COVID-19. By creating a lens that allows family members to submit pictures and stories, we were able to support Marked by COVID's vision in creating an accessible and unifying visual moment that captures memories from the communities most affected by COVID-19. I'll hand it over to Jonathan to give you an inside look at how the team utilized custom location AR to anchor the lens to the memorial site and the remote assets feature to power the experience, making it possible for so many people to remember their loved ones.
Thanks, Elena. I'm Jonathan Solichin, an AR engineering manager here at Snap. Let's walk through how the Marked by COVID AR experience is able to host over 400 memorials in a single lens. For this Lens Studio project, the Lens Cloud Remote Assets features allows us to store content in the cloud and remotely fetch and load assets into the lens, and load assets into the experience once users interact with the lens. In addition, this lens uses custom landmarker to allow us to put the memorial in a specific location in the world for users to find. In the resources panel, we can see these remote resources, which are downloaded once the users interact with the lens. Before remote assets, we were only able to add 100 pictures, and we nearly reached the total lens size limit. Here, you can see we're able to host hundreds of images in this lens using remote assets. While our total lens size is more than 8 megabytes, we deliver less than 8 megabytes when the user first downloads the lens, and the rest is downloaded from the remote assets. This allows us to submit the lens without any size limit errors. Let's try adding our own image to the cloud and this lens. We'll drag our images to the Lens Studio Resources panel from our computer so we can add it to our lens. Next, we'll select the Remote Assets button in the Resources panel. Here, I'm able to manage all my remote assets. You can see that when I select my team's organization, I can easily view all the assets we've uploaded to the cloud for this lens. Next, we'll select the Upload Asset button and choose the image we brought in earlier. Make sure it's added to the correct organization so your collaborators can see what you've uploaded later. Nice! The image has been uploaded with the information about it, including the file size, type, and where it's used. You can see this remote asset has automatically been added to our resources panel. Let's see this image now. We can grab a helper tool from the asset library to do so. Add the preview remote asset feature. Then follow the instruction and drag the assets to the object panel. We'll select the object that says Edit, click the Reference Asset field, and add the image we just added to the remote asset. In the Scene panel, we can now move our preview as we would with any object. Let's take a look at what this preview does and how it actually displays the remote assets. Double-click the Preview Remote Asset script in the Resource panel to open in the script editor. You can see at the top, we added an input for the remote assets. And at the very bottom, you can see that we called download asset on that input, which is the key function that loads our asset. Keep in mind that to make your lens efficient, you should only do this when you need to show the image, since this is the magic of remote assets. You can progressively download more content rather than downloading it all at once. This function then enables you to define two paths. In one, we get the asset, and the other, if we don't get the asset. This is important, since we want to make our lenses work on every device, even if the internet is slow or a device has limited memory or capacity. When we successfully download the asset, we want to use the remote asset. In this case, apply the texture onto an image. But if an issue happens, for example, the user's internet cuts out, your lens will still work. After all, the Snapchatter's experience is the most important thing. Since this is a preview, we just report the issue to the developer, but you should make a nice fallback for your lens. Use the preview feature to see if your assets work the way you want it to. The preview feature can adapt to any type of asset, whether a video or image or other files, and will display for you the same way it will appear for the Snapchatter. Pro tip, you can use this line to copy and paste in your own script. These types of assets can be uploaded to the remote asset storage directly. Texture, render mesh, audio track, object prefab, and script assets. Take a look at the remote asset documentation for additional details. So in this case, since we're trying to download images, we can see the remote asset is an asset texture and apply it to a material. In this case, it adds the texture to a mesh. Now that we know the image works, we can add this image to our lens. Let's delete this preview since we no longer need it. Let's take a look at the objects panel where we can see the object that controls our lens. We can add the image in our inspector panel by clicking Add Value. Remember that here, we're only adding the reference to our remote assets. Again, be sure to only download the actual assets when needed. Efficient lenses are engaged with more on Snapchat. This is a great benefit of the remote asset feature. You don't have to download everything all at once. That way, your lens can open super fast and you can download only what the user experiences. Now in this lens, the image is also attached to information about the person. Since the text data is small, we can just store that in the lens. What's great about remote assets is that it's very flexible. It's a pointer to our asset, so we can use it in any way we want, such as connecting it to data within the lens. In this case, we'll right-click the database and in the resources panel, double-click to edit the script editor. Then we can add the text data for the picture of the memorial, since the remote asset is only holding the image. Next, we can start a new entry by adding something to the existing script. The controller script will use this JavaScript object to provide our remote asset with some textual description. Let's try finding what we added in the lens. In the preview panel, click the search icon, scroll to the name we added, and click on the name we just added to select. Great, we successfully added a new image. Because we're in the same organization, I can save the lens and send the file back to a team member without having to include the actual images I've added, all thanks to Lens Cloud. This enables more efficient collaboration within teams. Now I'll pass it back to Elena for some closing thoughts.
Lens Cloud expands on what developers can build in augmented reality, from creating unique multi-user content that can be experienced together among friends and family, to bringing the world around you to life using location services. We can't wait to see what you create.